Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video we will see how to use serial register as an I/O expander instead of I2C based I/O expander. So let's get started. This is the datasheet of shift register IC which we will be using in this project. The main function of the shift register is serial in and parallel out. That is, it will receive the data on one pin and it will output the data on 8 pins. This is the logical diagram of the IC. Here is the pin out of the IC. These are the 8 pin output given on these pins. There is one more output pin and that can be connected to another shift register as an input. So that way we can connect multiple shift registers. And these are the input pins from controller, that is in our case Arduino. So with these 3 pins we can control the LCD and we can connect multiple LCDs as well on just 3 or 4 pins. Now we will see which module is suitable at what condition. So consider shift register for following points like small code footprint, less expensive, can connect multiple shift registers on same number of pins. Again, shift registers are faster when number of shift registers are limited, because if you want to change the single bit then you will have to send the data for all shift registers. There is no feedback on data transmission. The data transmission is not guaranteed. So consider following points if you want to use I2C port expander. That is, if you are already using I2C peripherals, then you don't have to waste two pins, I2C pins. Again, if you want to read port expander pin as well. Again, for a shift register, if you want to change a single bit, then you will have to send all the data. But in case of port expander, you just have to send the data to that particular node only. And the data transmission is guaranteed. This is the schematic of our module. As you can see in the schematic, components are very minimal. In the schematic, I have used one LCD connector, one shift register, again input connector, and some resistors and transistors. This is the board layout. So let's check how it looks in 3D view. This is the PCB of our module. PCB looks very small. I have assembled module as well. And this is the one. All the components are hand soldered with normal iron. We'll be using Arduino Nano in this project. Again, we will need few jumper wires. So let's do the connection. So in the connection, we'll connect shift clock to pin number 4, again serial data to pin number 3, and store clock to the pin number 5. All the connections are given in the code. And here also you can see the connections. In the code, as you can see, these are the pin definitions. We have connect shift clock to pin number 4, we have connect serial data to pin number 3, and we have connect store clock to pin number 5. So we have defined two macros for data and command. So these are the bit position of LCD. Again, this is the init sequence array. So this is the function which will change the order from LSB to MSB. This is the init LCD function. And this function will send the data on shift register. This is the enable function which is used in the LCD. Again, this is the print function which will print the data. Again, this is the clear display function. And this function will shift out the data on shift register. And so in the setup function, we are changing the pin mode to the output. Again, here we are initializing the LCD. And with print function, we are printing the data on LCD. So let's see the demo now. Thank you for watching. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe to the channel for more videos.